the Dark Lord, and I'm back in the motherfucking building.
The Dark Lady representing for Papa Legba today. What it do, boo?
All right, and today we're going to talk about the Divine Messenger, the Divine Trickster, the Opener of the Way, okay, the Old Man in the Crossroads, Papa Legba.
Why? You know what? I can't with you. Like, why you had to do all of that? Like, really?
I gotta do that.
No, you don't. Yeah, well, basically, we definitely are going to talk about a very, very powerful, I hate this microphone, very powerful divine energy, masculine energy, master sorcerer, master messenger, you know, the opener of the gateways, you know, a lot of people who are at least a little bit familiar with Vodou are familiar with Papa Legba. He's like one of the most popular deities. And he's also the messenger or the opener to be able to communicate with the other Loas. So if you trying to get to them, you can't do that unless you talk to Big Papa Legba.
Yeah, you know, the interesting thing about Papa Legba, so we got the opener of the way. We have several openers of the way. Yes. Right? In different cultures, right? Have the same exact role. Right? So Legba, Eshu, Ilegua, Tahuti, you know, all of these energies were the divine messengers or the divine openers of the way in different parts of the world, right? Mm-hmm. So Papa Legba represents the Haitian embodiment of that type of energy, okay? I would say the most ancient energy when we talk about the opener of the way would be Tahuti, all right? But it's all one and the same as an energy, and because of that, this is a very galactic energy, okay? You know, so Papa Legba has a very special seat in the universe, okay? And it's not just amongst the Loa, it is in the universe, you know? So this is something very galactic, okay? So a lot of this lecture is going to be about the divine messenger. Okay?
The divine messengers, we all have them. We all really need them. You know, like, it's the power of divination. It's the power of, you know, like, correcting our lives. And, you know, a lot of us have encountered different messengers. But have we encountered them in a way that Papa Legba delivers messages? You know, and it's not about him. For me, it's not about him being a trickster. It's about paying attention to the message, because, you know, you have to, you know, like, these energies are discerned as well. Like, they look at your energy and how you come to them, you know, so you definitely want to come correct when dealing with this energy. You know, he is considered the most loving when it comes to humans, because a lot of them, like I've said in other videos, they won't even rock with you. They'll just look at you like, who you talking to? What do you want? You know, but one thing I do love about Papa Legba is that he does have compassion, and the way he teaches lessons may not always be the way you want it, but you still getting what you asked for. You know, like, you may ask him to show you the way, but you may not ask in specifics. So you may not like how you're being shown certain things. You just have to, you know, like, be studious and pay attention to how he's delivering a message, you know. And it's like, he's more like a loving father. So he wants you to be able to elevate to the next level, you know. And the next level is actually beyond those crossroads, where we find ourselves faced with good decisions, bad decisions. It might be on family issues. It could be on how to move in a career or how to move in relationships. And, you know, like, he will definitely come to you with a divine message, giving it to you like, this is how you can move. You know, this is what makes him the perfect go-to if you're practicing Vodou or you're trying to come into the understanding of Vodou. He's one of the best, or the only best that I could think of, to help to correct certain errors in your life. You know, to me, he's kind of like a male version of Cali Mom. You know, he teaches hard lessons, but he loves you enough to get you to learn and understand the message that he is trying to bring across to you. And it's very profound. If you've ever been encountered with Papa Legba, you would know what I'm talking about. If you're encountering him in the future, you know, you're definitely going to know what I'm talking about, because the specific instruction I'm giving you after today is, when you get that message from him, write it down, and you'll definitely have a clearer understanding of the divine messenger and how he moves.
Very good. I like that. That was dope. That was like jewel dropping, like bam, bam, bam. For real. It was deep. She was deep, son. Nah, look. Now, it's funny. You said anybody getting into this, right? Mm-hmm. I would say, I'll take it further and also say, anyone getting into dealing with ancestral spirits, venerated spirits, primordial energy, any type of spirit workings, I would suggest the first energy that you practice with or get acquainted with, if you want to really get your feet wet and not get hurt, if your intentions are pure, all right, if you don't have a, you know, priest or priestess that you go to that can guide you, and you really want to self, you know,
solo practitioner.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. There's nothing wrong with that, because some of you are born solo. You know what I'm saying? You're not going to gravitate towards people as far as them teaching you, right? I would definitely go with Papa Legba. Mm-hmm. Hands down. Okay, and anybody experienced with any type of spirit dealings will tell you the same thing. Okay.
Even if you do initiate by the spirit, like, you don't always initiate through a priest or a priestess. Sometimes you will initiate through the spirit, through your dreams. And Papa Legba is the first one that you meet when initiating through Vodou.
Right. So, you know, and then, as she said, you know, this first one you got to go through. You got to get the green light from Papa Legba anyway. Okay, and also Papa Legba would definitely be the most kind, you know, as far as like spirit workings and stuff like that. If your intentions and your heart is pure and you do your due diligence in knowing the offerings, okay, candy, coffee, cigar. You know, if you know your, you know what I'm saying, if you do the vey-vey right and exact, all right, and you study the numbers and the numerology, the colors, okay, I can promise you that you know, you will be all right if you work with Papa Legba. Okay, so, you know, another thing I want to go deeper into, right, is the importance of the opener of the way in our life and how to navigate that and why it's important and where Papa Legba comes in play. You know what I'm saying? You got Jay-Z. I got the keys. Mm-hmm. All right. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? That opener of the way.
Yeah. I got the keys.
It's ultra important for you to get clearance. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Everywhere we go in life, there is going to be a representation of Papa Legba. Okay. So you could be trying to get into a particular industry and this person is a connect, mm-hmm. and that you got to go through this person. And if this person,
you gotta go
if you are favor, you are in favor of this person, mm-hmm. right? Then you're good. You know what I'm saying? If you are, you know what I'm saying? You go over here and you got, if you get, you're in favor of this other person over here, right? Now your whole career is set. Now, the funny thing with that, because this Papa Legba Eshu Elegua Tahuti energy is so fucking strong, watch the colors that this person wears that you gotta go through. Also, observe how old they are. Mm-hmm. Okay. So, you know, for example, I'm gonna give a quick example. All right. You know, in the biker world, right? In the biker world, you know, it was a person in New York you had to go through, and their name was Father Tom, right? And this person would clear you to have a biker gang to ride on the road. Some right. Legba shit going on right here.
Is a hierarchy.
This person had to clear you, right? You go to this person, they cleared you, you was good. Mm-hmm. Tell me how this person was older. You know what I'm saying? And they dressed like Papa Legba. Okay, they had the top hat, they had the pipe, right? They had the cane. They loved coffee. See, wow. You gotta understand that when you start dealing with Loa and Orishas and all that, these are not only living, breathing energies, okay, venerated spirits and stuff like that, but they are also fashions of your psyche. And once you really start understanding that, navigating this plane will be really smooth. Okay, so without homework for everybody watching this, find out the opener of the ways in your profession. All right, see who you gotta go through, see who got the keys already. Mm-hmm. All right, and then get that clearance. But I want y'all to, when you after you establish a good relationship with Papa Legba, to ask Papa Legba to assist you in that, and I promise you, your life will change.
Excuse me. I definitely agree. There's always, like, you know, there's always a respect factor when it comes to the elders, because we have to remember that, I'm not going to say all of them, but a lot of them are definitely, they hold keys to wisdom. They hold keys to understanding, you know, and my motto is, you know, I feel like the elders and the children are the most important parts of a community, you know, basically because, you know, and this is a important reason why you never give your children away and you never give your elders away, because the children are a clean slate and the elders are the one who carry the wisdom. If we give them away, then the wisdom dies with them. If we give our children away, they're never left to receive it. So only thing you have is the in-between. And then, you know, like, it kills the matriarch and the patriarch of the family. So it's definitely important to keep those two in the household, because you got to have somebody to give the keys to or to open the gates to.
Another thing about elder energy, right? Mm-hmm. A lot of the times, we often neglect elderly energy. Mm-hmm. And when we do that, there's certain degrees, right? Certain forms of wisdom that we miss out on. All right? So, a lot of you be on some, yo, I'm going to just do offerings to Oshun. Yeah, I'm going to just give Oshun this because she needs this. She, you know, Oshun needs that. And it's like, you know, the elders Papa Legba, right? Mm-hmm. So you not doing your Papa Legba offerings, you missing out on that serious divine wisdom. You missing out on those prophetic dreams. You missing out on those dreams where, you know, Legba could come through and give you a warning. Okay, don't do this. because this is a disaster right here. But because you neglected elderly energy, you missing out on the keys that point you in certain directions. Right. All right.
And I definitely agree okay. with that. You know, like having a sense of direction in life does help everything else run smoother. You know, like you might be a new parent. And, you know, new parents, we learn through going through the motions, you know, like especially if you don't have nobody in your life to tell you how to do X, Y, and Z, everything becomes a learning experience. But when you have the elder there, they're going to give you the guidance, you know, like to go about your life so you won't have to keep bumping your head up against the brick wall. That's Legba right there, you know.
Right there. Okay, that's Papa Legba in the
night. All day long, that's Papa Legba. You know, whether it's making good career decisions, you want to know if you should be an entrepreneur or should you keep clocking in a 9-to-5. Now, everybody ain't meant to be an entrepreneur the same way everybody isn't meant to be working in a 9-to-5. But those are the two, you know, like decisions that you might meet at a crossroads when you're trying to deal with your career.
You got that crossroads. Mm-hmm. And it's like, okay, now this is funny. This is a great scenario, right? So, because this applies to like half the damn chat group, right? So, all right, I'm working a 9-to-5. I'm tired of it and I want to do my own thing. Mm-hmm. And it's like you at that crossroads and you know that now whatever decision you make is going to change your life.
Right.
This is where Papa Legba comes in to assist you. You at that crossroads. You go to Legba. Papa Legba will show you how to get out of that 9-to-5. See, y'all got to learn how to use these or interact with these deities the right way. Okay? Don't be selfish. But, you know, learn when, you know what I'm saying? This is when Legba comes in, you know what I'm saying? Damn, I'm trying to get out of my 9-to-5. I'm at a crossroads here. I'm trying to, I'm contemplating divorcing my spouse. Legba comes in again, all right?
Or when should I have a baby?
When should I have a, you know what I'm saying? Crossroads, you know, directions. East, south, north, and west. You got to know your directions. All right.
Should I whoop my child ass for eating up all my
children? There's a, you know, one of the secrets, all right? One of the secrets, I'm going to just give y'all like a baby secret, all right? All Vevays have like hundreds of secrets in them, okay? Every single Vevay has a shitload of secrets in them. But one of the Legba secrets in the Vevay is the directions, okay? The directions. All right, the directions. All right, you got north, east, south, and west. All right, Legba is the OG, triple OG of the directions, north, east, south, and west. All right, north, east, south, and west. Okay, east, west, north, south, whatever. All right, this is the OG. All right, this is the guardian. This is the person, the deity that owns this. Right, this is the master in navigation. Yeah. All right. This is the, you know, you're talking about messenger, right? We're dealing with mercurial energy, Mercury. Yes. All right, we're dealing with the Grand Master Freemason. Okay, this is why 3 and 33 is amongst the numbers of Papa Legba.
And can't you
no more secrets for you, niggas.
But can't you kind of see it in the Vevey, though? I'm just saying. Like, I mean, I love drawing his Vevey, though. Like, wearing it, all that type of stuff. But, yeah, that was definitely a powerful degree when you're working with him. This is why it's important to get to know these Loas when you're dealing with them. You know, like, who wants to go through life not knowing how to move? You know, and throughout time, what we've done, you know, through religion, we've developed a oppressed mentality as if everything is against us. No, everything is against you when you're using somebody else's traditions and customs, but everything is for you when you go back into your own, you know, all of these degrees and stuff, like, it's ours, you know, for us to use. Like, these energies are, you know, elemental, but they are put here for us to learn lessons. You know, just like when you go into the comedic deities, when you go into the Orishas, the Loas, you know, like, they're lessons for us to navigate this plane. So definitely use them. Definitely get out of that fear of who's the devil and all that type of stuff. That's BS. Like, what we need to understand right now is these ancestors, these Loas, they all here for our greater purpose. And if we want to benefit in our lives, if we want to get to the next level, we should learn how to work with these energies as our own divine elevation. You know, if something's going wrong in our lives, like, it probably prevent a lot of going to jail. It'll prevent a lot of making bad relationship decisions, making bad career decisions, having children before we actually ready to, you know, like, we just jump straight into bed with each other nowadays. Like, we don't use no discernment and we end up in situationships. So now, and that's, and the reason why we make so many pitfalls is because we forgot to receive the ultimate guidance from our elders. The triple OGs.
You know what I'm saying? So, you know, we got elder spirits, we got elders that walk on this plane, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying, that carry the same energy straight up, right? This is straight DNA, right? You know what I'm saying?
It's the phone number.
Okay.
The blueprint.
And, you know, a lot of people do not really realize how much power Papa Legba actually has mm-hmm. to sit in the seat of being the divine messenger. Or the divine wisdom, all right? This energy is so old, okay? Like I said, it starts with Tahuti, okay? But this energy is so we're talking about Tahuti, we're talking about Thoth, mm-hmm. right? So now we're talking about something that is galactic, that stretches before the planet was created, all right? So when you're dealing with that energy, we're dealing with galactic power.
You know he okay. got so, if he holds the keys to
okay. Okay. All right. You know, scenario here. Legba is dealing with the road, directions, mm-hmm. right? Traveling. Okay. A lot of times, when you're on the highway and you want to get home safe, Jesus is not going to get your ass home safe. It will be this guy. All right, the person who has the person who has dominion over the directions is responsible for keeping you alive and also for taking you the hell up out of here. All right? So
you say Legba take the wheel.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, let Legba take the wheel. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, everybody that's done checked out on the highway, Legba has something to do with it. And, you know, it's funny. Because when you crossroads, Bone Thugs, remember that?
At the crossroads, now, so you won't be lonely.
Now, everybody know that song, right? Mm-hmm. Who the fuck you think is taking everybody up out of here when he doing this and they just passing
the
out?
Oh yeah, that was Papa Legba.
That's straight Papa Legba.
They so
see,
I
now
them.
The funny thing with Papa Legba is, like I said, this energy is everywhere. You gotta look everywhere, all right? Like, everywhere you look in your neighborhood, you're gonna see Papa Legba somewhere.
You seen in that video when all right. He brought the dove back to life.
He brought the dove back to life. All right. He's taking life. He's transporting you to the underworld, mm-hmm. all right, or the other realm. And he's also giving life or being in that dimension. Assisting, you know what I'm saying? So Papa Legba can also heal you, bring you back to life, or prevent death. Do you know how much motherfucking power that is, yo? So when y'all deal with Papa Legba, stop being simple-minded and go, oh, that's the trickster. Nah, go deeper than that, you know what I'm saying? This energy deals with so much. You know, that's why I implore you, when we do this Papa Legba ritual as a group, I want y'all to work with Papa Legba for the entire month. Mm-hmm. All right, and never neglect this energy. All right.
The first Monday, from this Monday to the first to the next Monday of the exact day. You know, because, like, for those who don't know, today is his day, you know.
Right, Monday's Papa Legba days.
Okay. Monday is Papa Legba days, what's but his colors? His colors are red and black, which represents the life and the death, you know, or having the keys to different realms, you know. So that's what makes him so dope. Like, you know, like, I would treat Papa Legba like that's my granddad or something, you know. Like, he has that type of energy.
Oh, red, black, and white sometimes.
Oh, yeah, and sometimes white as well. You know, so when you're fresh and you're dealing with him, you definitely want to go into the red and white. You know, I'm more so a necromancer, so, you know, I deal with the red and black because I like to be dark about mine. But, hey, gotta love them ancestors. Love working with them, you know.
I want to talk about Papa Legba in Papa Legba in divination. Mm-hmm. Tahuti in divination, Legba in divination, Eshu in divination. All right, your diviner right here too, divine messenger. Mm-hmm. All right, so this is
prophetic dream.
A lot of the energy. That prophetic dreams, right? That's divination. You know what I'm saying? Also, the prophets. All right. So a lot of your prophets, right? You know, they're not coming with Shango.
No.
They're not coming up with Oshun. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? We've had a lot of prophets on this planet, and they've all carried that Papa Legba energy, that divine wisdom.
Yeah, they always older. Okay. You're always going to find...
Even if they're younger, they older.
Right.
You know, I mean, you like, know what I mean?
Look at Elijah Muhammad. Look at Malcolm X. You know, like... what's his name? Dang. He just passed for him not too long ago.
You know, it's funny what you said. You named these two people. Mm-hmm. In their organization... They were called the divine minister or the divine messengers.
Yeah. Yeah.
So this is real stuff here, all right? So, you know, the divine messenger usually is the liaison between the gods and the people or the supreme being and the people.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? This is the liaison. This is Mercury right here. This is communication. You know, this is the most important... chess piece right here. It's the most important chess piece. So, you know, y'all gotta be acquainted with Papa Legba. I don't care if you practice Haitian Vodou or not.
Or even if you just get into metaphysics or
I don't care if you just getting into metaphysics, occult, you gotta know who Papa Legba is. You gotta pay homage to Papa Legba. It don't matter what you practice. All right, it don't matter if you initiate it or not. Pay homage to Papa Legba, but that's the OG. You know what I'm saying? You got to pay homage to the OG. And anyone in true occultism or sorcery understands that. This is why you got, who made a song on Papa Legba? Elton John, I think. I think it was Elton John. But Papa Legba's everywhere. Okay, Papa Legba's on your damn basketball court. Oh, that's another secret. I ain't going to give y'all that one, though.
I mean, just pay attention, and it'll pretty much give you the secret itself. What, you want me to read some of the comments in the group chat?
No, in a second. Yo, okay. If y'all have questions in the chat, let us know. If you have questions on Papa Legba in the chat, let us know. Yeah. The next thing I wanted to talk about, though, was, like, getting the okay.
Oh, yeah, you definitely need the okay to get the keys.
A lot of you are right, to get the keys, like she said. Like, a lot of you are, like, y'all be doing rituals, right? And be like, yo, my ritual ain't work. And it's like, did you get clearance? You know? There's a lot of you now, especially a lot of y'all working with, like, Oshun. And it's like, did you get the green light from Papa Legba? Okay, and then a lot of people tell me that, and I'll be like, okay, so you got the green light, and I'm like, how did you get the green light? And they be like, well, I did a Papa Legba thing. Okay, a Papa Legba thing. So Papa Legba gave you the message, and if you don't get clearance, if you don't get a sign to go, then do not move forward. This is what a lot of y'all mess up at.
Do not go. Do not collect 300 points.
Right. You know what I'm saying? This is where a lot of people, I see they mess up. They don't. Y'all don't know the chain of command.
And you can't go into this greedy.
You cannot.
I say that in every video we do when it comes to Orishas, Loas, deities. Like, I don't care. Because I'm telling you, all this auric field, all that, the astral field, they can see that.
They can see all that.
So they already know if you on some Fugazi from the gate. And they will close the gates on you before they open them. Because they'll be like, okay, this person needs to mature. They got a lot that they need to learn.
Right.
So we're going to let them fall back until they learn a proper way. You know, but if you are favored, you will get that dream to say, well, this is what you do.
Papa Legba is also responsible for closing the gates. Mm-hmm. So a lot of us, you know what I'm saying, we do magic or whatever. We don't follow protocol. We have these crazy egos. And then there comes a point where nothing is working no more, yo. And we like, damn, son, none of my rituals are working. Papa Legba just shut it down.
Dried up, right? Michael Hoover back.
He shut down your access to the other world. All right?
Especially if you're just okay. Trifling.
Learn how to navigate.
Do not come into that with the okay. Ego, because they do not like that.
Learn how to navigate. You know what I'm saying? Learn how to establish lines of communication. Going back to Mercury.
Yeah. Okay. All right. So definitely when you're working with him on the altar. I'm sorry. Because we have to understand that an altar is more than just a place where we put lowers or relatives. You know, we need to understand that your altar is sacred because it's an antenna. And it actually opens up different realms. You know, and it opens up the gates. You know, like, that's where you're going to get most of your contact. That's where you're going to do most of your rituals. You know, so even if you wanted to talk to your relatives and get a clearer antenna, you could still go through Papa Legba just to talk to grandmama and them. You know, so definitely having that altar, having the things that he likes, developing that relationship. Don't overthink it. Don't say, well, I did this and nothing happened. You know, like, don't come into the situation in doubt. Come into the situation with, look, I'm trying to better my life. What are my steps? You know, that needs to be a specific question that you're asking him, because he got a lot of keys. So therefore, he has a lot of steps. So you want to be specific, very specific when you're dealing with Papa Legba. You know, you want to, because, like, he's the divine messenger, so he does give divination. Yeah, and he does remove obstacles.
Yeah, Mystic Rose says, yes, correct. Elton John was very aware of Papa Legba. Check that song Elton John made about Papa Legba. That joint was, you know what I'm saying?
I personally haven't heard it.
Yeah. Check that out. Everybody check that out. And there was something I had to say. Damn, I shouldn't have cut you off.
It's okay. All
right. So Elton John, and then what the fuck I had to say? Oh yeah, that's what it was. Papa Legba is also.
Oh yeah, keep them pennies.
Yeah, keep them pennies, yo.
I save all my pennies. Okay. I be looking at people crazy when they drop them, and I'm like, but you could have dropped them pennies at the crossroad. If you got 16 of them Jones, like, why would you just throw pennies on the ground without it being a good reason?
You know what's funny? When you do the Papa Legba rituals, even the simple ones, I swear, yo, this is the deity that most people will tell you that they had a supernatural encounter with. Mm-hmm. They gonna have a. They either gonna have a dream that night, or it's gonna be something in the way, because he's so wise and profound, the way he appears is gonna be like, wow. Mm-hmm. You know, it's always like some dope, profound, classy. Like, yo, that was gangster how he did that. Right. It's always like, that's Papa Legba right there.
Let me tell y'all, like,
you know,
last year, I had my cousins. This is too funny. I had my cousins to work with Papa Legba for the first time. And I gave them, like, a simple ritual. Everybody, you know, like, who wasn't working ended up getting jobs. They told me about their dreams. They were so excited that they couldn't even get it out their mouth good enough. And it was just too funny, you know. And right to this day, like, my cousin is learning how to set up an altar, you know, and he really is, like, sincere about working with Papa Legba. You know, like, he's dealt with healing, you know, from past loss dealing with Papa Legba, you know. So I'm telling y'all, like, if I can get a hood dude to work with Papa Legba, just somebody who ain't ever in his life thought about African spirituality on any type of level,
straight universal energy,
just off the rip, just changed his life, and he's still doing good, you know. Shout out to y'all, cuz I love y'all,
you know. You know, all my occultists out there, everybody watching this video, do your Papa Legba rituals every single Monday. Mm-hmm. Don't slack.
Yeah, if you're going to be diligent, be diligent.
For 3 months straight, and watch where you end up in life. Right. That's my word. Everybody in this journey, life is going to change. Okay? Every Monday, consistently. All right? It's a universal energy.
And it's all about repetition. Okay. So that every Monday is repetition. That 90 days is repetition.
Yep.
You know?
Yep.
And repetition is the foundation of magic. So, yeah.
Yep. I'm going to answer a few questions in the chat, and then we wrapping this joint up. Okay. J-Star asks, where is the crossroads exactly?
Well, the crossroads... like, let's just say, for example, you may be done with a certain ritual. The crossroads would be that four-way stop sign down the street from your house, or the nearest crossroad, you know, at the corner. Like, you may not live at the corner. You might live, like, right in between. So the first four-way stop in your area, mainly when you're dealing with magic, you want to face the north. So you're going to deal with the north crossroad, the closest to your house. Oh, yeah, and railroads. That's considered a crossroad as well. Because you got the cars going one way, you got the trains going another way. Right. You know, so, yeah, definitely.
Regina Jarrett said, I don't miss no Mondays, LOL.
I know that's real.
Man, what if you're a messenger?
Did somebody say Panky Promise?
If you're a messenger sign, then, you know what I'm saying, you might have some Legba in you.
With the energy. You work with the energy the strongest.
You know what I'm saying? You probably crowned in a Legba.
Right. And you're the matriarch or patriarch for your family to pass that wisdom down and to give your children or grandchildren the keys.
Kim Taylor say, can you assist me in setting up a ritual for Papa Legba?
Oh, yes, definitely. Yeah.
We're going to all do that. But Kim, just call me. We'll talk tonight. And I got you.
It's a lot of Papa Legba fans in here.
Yeah, of course. Just the OG.
They drop their pennies off.
I know everybody doing their Papa Legba ritual.
The 16 penny ritual is pretty much like the easiest.
No.
One. I think that would be like the most elementary.
I'm going to give y'all one thing to do with Papa Legba, and we're going to wrap this lecture up, y'all. So, first thing I want y'all to do is draw this perfectly. Okay, perfect, all right? Draw it for 30 days straight, all right? Every day, okay? Every day, because, you know, people want rituals, you know. And the first thing y'all got to understand is, yeah, we're really not going far until we know how to dial the phone number, okay? Draw it 30 days straight. And second thing I want y'all to do is leave every single offering that you know of that Papa Legba has or where this piece of paper is, all right? Don't ask for anything at all. Within 30 days, your dreams with Papa Legba is going to get really, really vivid, all right? When you start having conversations with Papa Legba.
Yeah.
All right? All right. So that is a really powerful ritual that I wanted to give y'all. And we about to wrap this up.
Yeah, because I'm trying to eat my chili. Like,
okay. Anything, last things you had to say?
All I would say is come pure in heart. Come with the receiving heart. Because remember, again, we're talking about the messages, and it's all about receiving his energy, receiving what he has to offer us. That's the most important thing. You know, come sincere. Don't come asking for stuff off the rip, because that's like the quickest way to get turned down.
All right. We wrapping this up, but it's commercial time. So you already know, go to http://www.oodofroyalbloodline.com. Buy our Ood. All right. Hit me on the inbox if you need to purchase a Royal Bloodline hoodie. And we do have Papa Legba hats. This is a Ogun. But we do have Papa Legba hats, y'all.
And shirts.
And shirts. So inbox me if you need that. And all right, you ready?
You know where to find us. Ooh, the Royal Bloodline.com.
Ready?
Yes.
You already know where to find us. Ooh, the Royal Bloodline.com. SevenSageMetaphysics.com. Like this video. Subscribe. Share it. Peace.
I'm about to go eat this chili, though.
Yo, but one more thing, y'all. One more thing before I wrap this up. Go in the group. Let everybody know how you like the video. All right. Peace.
Peace, y'all.
All right. Take it off.